Today, we'll be reacting to a bloke talking about steroids who doesn't know anything about steroids. What an idiot.
After 24 hours of quitting steroids, you will feel extremely tired and fatigued because of how the steroids have messed with your hormone systems, specifically your gonadotropin-releasing hormone.
It's not an MDMA tab. It's not a cup of coffee. You're not going to suddenly crash after stopping injecting anabolic steroids. And the reason why is because of the drug's half-life. So half-life is the amount of time required for half the active substance to reduce in the body. So let's take a cup of coffee as an example. Caffeine's half-life is 5 hours. So if you have 100 milligrams of caffeine, in 5 hours' time, you've got 50 milligrams. In the case of steroids, we'll just use like testosterone enanthate as it's the most common testosterone used. The half-life of testes is around about 7 days. So if you were to administer 250 milligrams on a Monday, by the following Monday, you've still got 125 milligrams circulating in the system. So there's gonna be absolutely zero crash after 24 hours.
Steroids block the release of GnRH. This is why steroids can shrink your testicles.
That is true. That is true, mate. You are true. So when you start to administer anabolic steroids, you start to shut down. Hence why your testicles, the balls, your cojones, they start to shrink. Mine shrunk, as the many others. Mine are back now, though. Oh, they're back.
Testosterone binds to cells in the kidney to stimulate the release of erythropoietin, EPO, which promotes red blood cell production. With the lack of testosterone from quitting steroids, your body has less red blood cell production, which means less oxygen and less energy for cells.
Yeah, I mean, we know that testosterone stimulates erythropoiesis, but to suggest that there's any form of impact on RBC after 48 hours is wild. I honestly don't know where this bloke's getting his information from.
At 72 hours, your sleep is now affected by the low testosterone. The exact mechanism that testosterone affects sleep is not known, but there have been plenty of research showing that poor sleep can reduce testosterone levels and vice versa.
Yeah, I mean, that is true. Back in 2014, Gary Witter did some research on the relationship between sleep disorders and testosterone in men and found that men with low testosterone overall had poorer sleep quality. But to suggest that after 72 hours of ceasing steroids, your sleep quality or sleep will be affected is, I would go as far as to say, incorrect.
After a week of quitting, you will feel muscle aches and joint pain because testosterone usually promotes the release of anti-inflammatory cytokines from your immune cells.
You are not going to suddenly get some sort of acute delayed onset muscle soreness after a week of stopping anabolic steroids. Let's revert back to that 250 meg that we spoke about before. In a week's time, you will still have 125 milligrams circulating around your system. Based on your cycle length, that's still going to put you more than likely in a supraphysiological range. So supraphysiological means outside of that physiological range of testosterone. So in terms of soreness and strength adaptations, there's going to be no decrease in that at all.
So it is after a week that the gains start to noticeably go away.
What do you know about gains? No, that's rude. That is rude of me. I retract that statement.
At 1 month, you may notice erectile dysfunction.
Okay, we may be on the same page here. 1 month after ceasing anabolic steroids, you might start to see some impacts of low testosterone. 1 month would equal 4 weeks. 4 weeks is around about 4 half-lives of the drug. You're looking around about 4 to 5 half-lives of a drug before it's eliminated or cleared from the system. So if you were, say, on 50 nanomolar of testosterone, in 4 or 5 weeks' time, you might start to be in those single digits, which may, for some people, impact things like erectile dysfunction.
This by proxy decreases the follicle-stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone, which help chemically message the testes to produce testosterone.
Oh no, we're off the same page again. We were doing so well. Follicular stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone is suppressed very quickly on the onset of taking anabolic steroids. So on the screen now is just some examples of my blood work when I'm on cycle. FSH and LH is suppressed. It's like negligible. It's like 0.03. So to suggest that FSH and LH decrease after coming off anabolic steroids is incorrect. FSH and LH don't stay consistent whilst you are on. Potentially if you were taking something like HCG, but it's not really something that we recommend you do whilst on cycle.
After 3 months of stopping steroids, depressive symptoms and mood changes may get worse without testosterone replacement therapy.
Yeah, I mean, I was pretty depressed in November/December time, and I came off September, October, November, December. So yeah, I mean, 3 months you're looking at, for someone that's not taking any post-cycle therapy, so PCT, And for someone like myself who has just come off completely cold turkey, you're looking at the clearance time, and then you're seeing if your HPTA will restart itself without the use of other drugs. So there's going to be a period of time whereby you are waiting for that occurrence to happen where your testosterone is bottomed out for a prolonged period of time. And I didn't get any blood work done in that period of time, and I should have. I got some blood work sent off, but it never came back because there was a problem with the lab, which I think psychologically was actually beneficial for me, because come January time, when I got my bloods done again and FSH and LH and testosterone was back in range, I was like, fantastic. But there was a big, big dip for me. And it was around about November, December time. And that would have been the time whereby nothing is going on. And environmental factors, of course, living in England, had a new business, a decrease in subscribers. That could also be playing a massive part. But I think the lack of testosterone was probably the main reason.
But the former users still had testes 4.9 milliliters smaller than non-steroid users, which means it could take well over a year for your testes to get back to normal size.
Yeah, I can get behind that, because I don't think my testicles are back to their regular size, their final form. Maybe they're still getting there, but there's definitely a... I don't think they're back to their regular... They're definitely bigger than they were when they were on anabolic steroids, but I'd say that only started to come around when I was in Ibiza back in May. I was in the shower and I was like, has anyone dropped 2 tennis balls in the shower? Has anyone lost 2 oranges? No, they're my testicles.
There may be ways to slowly reduce your steroid use in order to not create such a strain on your body. Again, you need to talk to a doctor about this.
Slowly reducing steroid usage isn't going to do anything, because you are prolonging the inevitable. So even if you were to go from like 250 milligrams down to maybe like 125 and then 100, you're still going to have to go through the process of the half-life of that testosterone to go through 4 or 5 cycles to then bottom out and then be in a position whereby you can either go, right, I'm going to wait for my HPTA to restore itself, or I'm going to take post-cycle therapy. So I don't agree that slowly reducing anabolic steroids. You could potentially argue that switching to a quicker acting ester may be beneficial. So you might want to start to introduce maybe like a testosterone propionate whilst you're taking testosterone enanthate. And the reason behind that would be because propionate's half-life is less than enanthate, then in theory, the recovery process may be a little bit quicker. So that may be something to potentially get behind. But to slowly reduce like test D over time, it isn't going to do much at all.
Or you just never start taking steroids in the first place and you don't have to worry about this as much.
Fuck that, take gear, be an alpha male. No, I'm joking, don't do that. This is probably a good time for me to wrap up my experience or my story. I'm sure many people know, but I took steroids for about 10 years, competed during those 10 years. I stopped competing back in 2021, but I convinced myself that the best idea was to stay on TRT. And I think it was because I was pranging out. Psychologically, I don't think I was ready to come off gear. I had a couple of holidays booked. I was seeing someone. I went to Marbella and I just got into that. Okay, next month I'm going to come off, but I've got this event. I've got to stay on TRT. So I actually made a shift in physique development training, went into more running and Hyrox back in 2022, August, September time. And I thought this will be a good opportunity for me to stop TRT. So it was also at a time where Dr. Deem and Joe Jeffries were doing some work with their athletes who didn't take PCT, highlighted their blood work and their ability to restore their HPTA and testosterone without post-cycle therapy. So I thought, let me give it a go. Let me document the process. Well, I think it'll be really interesting for my viewers and my subscribers. I have got quite a lot of content and videos during that period. You just need to look on my channel. But I ceased in August, September. And like I said, my toughest month was the December. And then I started to see the light in January. So I don't know if I need to get into the nitty gritty as to how I felt. But I mean, I was struggling. Joe, Mr. Joe Brightman as well, also came off. He was a little bit further in front of me. And he was relaying back to me like, oh, I can't get out of bed. And I was thinking, oh God, have I got all this to come? And lo and behold, I got to that period where I was struggling to get out of bed. Like I said, there was a lot of personal stuff going on at that time, but I don't think that personal stuff would have affected me that much. I.e. if I was to have continued TRT whilst the new business was taking off and personal issues were happening, I don't think it affected me that much. But there was definitely some days where I was like, I genuinely don't want to get out of bed here. Like I don't, I've got to go and do some mad Hyrox run. And I'm like, I don't want to do it. But the runner's high you get, you know, that big serotonin and dopamine hit you get after a run is crazy. So I started to get like addicted to that. And that's how I channeled my energy into doing that. But my biggest slump, like I said, was around about December, November, December time. And that would have been when my testosterone was completely bottomed out on zero and I was waiting for my natural testosterone to kick in. As I said, if I didn't get any blood work done, or if I got some blood work done again in January and it was low, then I would have probably looked at taking on board some PCT. But the reason for me not taking PCT was just, as I said before, can I get my testosterone back without taking other drugs? If I can do that, big win. If it didn't work, then I would have leveraged with PCT and post-hoc therapy drugs and then hopefully been able to restore my testosterone. So there we go. I hope we managed to clear a few things up and just highlight why this video was in part incorrect due to the half-lives. You're suddenly not going to start to feel sore or tired 24 hours or even a week after stopping anabolic steroids, and the reasons why is what I've explained in the video. That is all from me. I'm now going to go and watch the mighty Arsenal thrash Tottenham. I'm going to lose now, aren't I? I'm going to lose after I said that. I'll see you very soon. Thank you for watching this video. Any questions at all, hit them in the comment section below with regard to steroids or my usage or whatever, how you're feeling. Drop a comment and I will get back to you. Thank you. Good night. Much love.